Thank you. Thank you. I Thank you. Knight c4 was the first draw, but I decided to take risks with it, to play this position with knight c2. Maybe knight c2 is objectively not the best move.
It worked.
Oh, yeah, I mean, in complication somehow, yeah. But, yeah, but
the
draw
could be four moves.
Instead of knight b6, if you just take him b4, group b8. There is some.
Yeah.
There is d2.
Just
d2.
Can I take d2?
No. I take b4 first.
But then I've got queen takes b4.
Yes, but queen takes d2. I have rook on d8 and queen on d7. Yes. Of course, I'm bishop b4 up there, rook a b. Okay, just take on b4 with bishop and need d2.
And I need.
No, no, that's, no, you played completely correctly. I mean, took the rook, and this was correct. And, and then, I think objectively, I should play knight x4.
Yeah, with the draw, yeah.
Pawn takes. Queen takes king d1, but there is no more draw.
Yeah.
Okay, I was thinking for a long time and decided to take some risks, but obviously knight c2, well, shouldn't be the best move.
Take. How could I have played better there?
No.
Take, you took an h2.
Okay, I should have won the queen c3. I completely blundered
it. Yeah, so you start for you.
And then, fortunately, there was still this queen d6. I'm still in the game, at least.
But I can never take all of 6, and you get this pawn.
Yeah.
And then you're safe, because you get the 8 as well.
Yeah, it's a little bit
like... 6, and then I can...
But... Okay, bishop b4, I was... play just bishop c3, bishop takes, pawn takes. But then I can just play queen c5 and take this knight on e8. Oh, I felt that with this, all these pawn weaknesses, somehow I should have compensation at least to draw, so I'm not risking that much. That's what I felt.
Yeah. But after bishop for king d6, what do I do?
So bishop d3, I also take on h2.
Just with the queen on b6, the same thing.
Then I would probably like to do it. So c takes d5 is not dangerous, yeah? Just take c.
Then you take b3.
And then
take knight.
Yeah.
So, then you get on the square on b4.
No. Now I realize that I studied this position long ago, but then I forgot it.
Yes. You're gonna miss a knight. He's on Russian team champion. When we played last year in the FD World, we have prepared an improvement of the game against the United States.
I find out what the fuck I prepared this time. No, this time my position was dangerous in the game, but then the implications somehow worked well. Yeah, and then I was just too straight. I mean, night before in the field, my position is just okay, where there was no need to play like this.
No, you could just play with B8.
Yeah, okay, for A3.
But A3 you'll be continuing.
I had a feeling you were going to go for this. No, but maybe this should be fine because of what you just said. Okay, I have to calculate a lot of this. Because knight B6 so far you don't really have queen B7, and then I have knight A8, I have knight B5, and there I probably find my way in implications. So with bishop B4 at least I get change the bishops instead of knight before bishop before. So I get to change the bishops. And then just continue normal game but without sacrificing the pawn. And then maybe strategically I have better bishops. Because obviously with two bishops if you get A3 you're okay.
Yeah.
But if I play bishop, yeah, bishop before is probably also,
bishop before, yeah.
Yeah, that would be a classical chess move after some thought. But I was so excited with some ideas of tactics and that was too much.
Yeah, we just continue. You have A3 and yeah, you've got a good position. Because you've got the black squares. Yeah. Right, so I should find some improvement earlier.
Today, so the first two games today I played just like 1600 players. I mean, it's,